Hi, everybody. Good evening. Good evening.
Hello, teacher. Good evening.
Hi, Richard. Hello. Good evening. Hello. Hi, guys. How are you? How's everything going?
Good evening, teacher.
Hi, Norbert. Hi, Richard. Let me see. Danis, Guadalupe, good evening.
Hi, good evening.
Pedrina, hello, hello. Hey, Jackie. Veo a Carlos también. Clary, ¿qué tal, chicos? Jocelyn, how are you? ¿Cómo los trató el Día de la Independencia, guys? ¿Salieron de casa? What did you do?
Super cool.
Yeah, vi las fotos. I saw the pictures. Oh. I saw your pictures. So nice. Yeah. I'm glad you enjoyed it. Guys, what did you do yesterday? ¿Qué hicieron yesterday? Did you stay there? Pedrina?
Excellent. Aquí en my house.
You stayed in your house. Amazing. Okay. That's important too. Que podamos descansar un poquito, right? That you can, you know, rest a little. That you can be with your family. That's nice. Nice, nice. So, Karina, hi. Anita, good evening. Hello.
Good evening, teacher.
¿Qué tal? ¿Cómo están? How are you?
I just arrived.
To your house?
Yes.
Wow. Thank you so much for that. Okay. Gracias por conectarse like right on time. Jocelyn, hello. Voy por allá, Jocelyn, I think. Yes. ¿Qué tal, Miss? How are you?
Good, teacher. Good day.
Good. Okay. Did you stay at home? Mr. Lopez, hello. ¿Se quedaron en la casa, guys? Did you stay at home yesterday? ¿Salieron? ¿Fueron a dar una vuelta? Nothing. ¿Durmieron más? ¿Did you sleep a little longer?
Hello, teacher. Good evening. Good evening.
Hi, Carlos. Hello. Good evening. How are you?
Fine. Yesterday, I rested in my home.
And ah, very good.
Wash in the washing machine. The mm-hmm. rest of the week
in the washing machine. So yesterday, you were like really doing the laundry?
Yes.
Oh, okay. Nice. Well, todo es importante.
I saw the match of Champions League
yesterday. I didn't know there was a match yesterday, but okay, sounds good. All right, so thanks everybody, gracias por unirse a today's session. El día de ahora es pues nuestra última sesión de módulo, guys. This is session number 20 from beginners or basic number one. After today, well, vamos a avanzar un peldaño más, vamos a intermediate, right? Así que I'm like super excited, especially because hemos estado juntos un par de meses, you know, and we have seen your progress. So that's super, super amazing. Teníamos una actividad para el día de ahora, right? Y vamos a preparar una historia. We were going to prepare like a little story. So, of course, vamos a aprovechar para lograr escucharlas y aprovechar a escuchar sobre todo ese avance, you know, how much we have moved or learned and practiced desde módulo 1 hasta este punto so far. Of course, at the end of the session, vamos a tomar también la foto de módulo, right? That's important, para que vayan guardando ahí, you know, like the whole process. And yeah, so let me get started. Voy a iniciar tomando asistencia. Si me pueden ayudar con su camarita un momento, that would be amazing. And y me regalen porfa confirmación también, just para que nos quede constancia acá, que sus voces and everything. Permítame. Ahora es viernes. ¿Qué día es ahora, guys? Jueves, right?
Jueves.
Ok,
jueves.
Me siento so lost. Por alguna razón sentía que ayer era viernes. I felt yesterday was Friday. Creo que es por el día libre. Probably that was why. Ok. Anita, ¿me regala confirmación, porfa?
Present, teacher. Hello.
Gracias. Hello. Thank you so much for joining. Brian, creo que escuché la voz de Brian.
Present,
thank you so much. Danis.
Present.
Gracias. Dolores. Saray todavía no. Eduardo. Guadalupe.
Present, miss.
Gracias. Jackie, por ahí vi a Jackie.
Present.
Gracias. Jocelyn.
Present, teacher.
Thank you so much. Ignacio. Ignacio todavía no. Norberto.
Teacher.
Norbert. Gracias, Norbert. Marvin. Marvin Bonilla. Alex todavía no. Marvin López. Marvin López la vi por ahí hace unos segundos. Solo me regala confirmación, porfa. Gracias, Marvin. Clary.
Hello, miss.
There you go. Thank you so much. Moses. Not yet. Nelson. Quizás todavía está en el trabajo. Pedrina.
Present, teacher.
Gracias. Ricardo. René.
Present, 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 present.
Gracias, René. Thank you so much. Ricardo.
Present, teacher.
Thank you so much. Mabel.
Present.
Creo que se está conectando Dolores. Hola, Dolores. Hello, Saray.
Hello, Miss. Present.
Thank you so much. There we go. Creo que también acabo de ver a Moses por ahí. I saw Moses. Moses. Yeah, thank you so much, Moses. Let me just check it out. Mabel. Creo que no. Brenda. Carlos. A Carlos lo acabo de escuchar. I just heard him.
Present.
Gracias. Claudia. Claudia. I don't see her. And Karina. La acabamos de escuchar también.
Present, teacher.
Thank you so much. Alrighty, and thank you guys for getting your camera on. Okay, let me just present my screen para que veamos algunas de las actividades for today. So vamos a hacer un repaso simple past, but of course vamos a hablar bastante. You are going to be talking a lot and listening a lot. So let me get started here. Tenemos one-on-one con Mabel, but espero que nos acompañe. Okay, first, let's take a look at the following. Hola.
Hi, miss.
Hello. Oh,
hello.
Miss, tenemos one-on-one.
Yes.
Aprovecho que ya
todavía no estoy en casa, pero voy a ir escuchando mientras llego, porque entra.
Vaya, perfecto, no se preocupe. Acá, that's nice, nice. Okay. Guys, we are going to get started with the next activity. It says, listen to the description of the following people and guess the name. Do you recognize these people? Do you know who they are?
Oh, yes.
Who do you see? Who do you recognize?
Christine.
The President Kennedy.
Okay, Kennedy. Who?
Freddy. Freddy.
La Madre Teresa, teacher.
Oh, okay, Freddy. Teresa. Freddy. Freddy.
Presley.
Oh, Presley, okay.
Presley.
I thought you meant like Freddie Mercury. I was like, what?
No.
Okay. Freddy, okay. Presley,
Michael Jackson.
I mean, yes. Michael Jackson, okay.
Yes. Diana.
Mm-hmm.
John Lennon.
Mm-hmm. John Lennon.
Okay.
Yes.
Guys, who is this?
Albert Einstein. Albert
Einstein. Ah, Einstein. Okay. Yeah. So that's Einstein. And this one?
Madonna.
Ah, okay. Very good. Very good. We got it. So what are we going to do? les voy a dar, I'm gonna read, right? Les voy a leer, de hecho, una breve descripción. I'm gonna read a little description here. And ustedes me ayudan adivinando a quién estoy describiendo.
Okay.
Denme un segundo, give me just a sec. Wait a second. Okay, so se me dobló. Okay, this is kind of double. Okay. Let me just go ahead and share this with you. Todavía logran ver mis fotos, right? You can still see my pictures.
Yes.
Okay, nice. So let me read it for you. Y ustedes me dicen a quién estoy describiendo. You tell me the name of the person that is in these pictures. Number one, this person studied at Harvard University. He was married with Jacqueline Lee. And he had 4 children. He was from USA, and he was born in 1917.
Young F. Kennedy.
Yes, very good. Yes. That was Young F. Kennedy.
Yeah.
Good, you got one. That was Moises, I think. Okay, next person. Okay. This person was born in December 1901. He was a film producer and he worked giving the voice of different like cartoons, or he was the voice, only the voice of some animated, you know, cartoons. So he invented Mickey Mouse.
Walt Disney.
Yes, Walt Disney, exactly. Do you see Walt Disney there?
What is
it? No, I don't know.
Walt Disney is in the picture. It is, let me present it over.
Mother Teresa.
Yeah, next to Mother Teresa. Next to, exactly. Next to Mother Teresa.
Mother. Ah.
Yeah, that was next to Mother Teresa. Okay, next. Okay. This is a woman and she was a dancer. She started her career in modern dance. She was married with Sean Penn. She has a daughter and her name is Lourdes.
Madonna.
Yes, very good. Okay, wow, how do you know that? Okay, very good. Let me go with somebody else. Okay, this is a really famous person. She was born in 1967. Her second name is Fiona, and she has been a winner, you know, of some Oscar awards. She has been considered one of the best actress in the industry. She is very famous because she has participated in romantic comedy. So she acts a lot in romantic comedy. I cannot tell you the movie because that is too easy. So, who?
Julia Roberts.
Yes, Julia Roberts. Okay, good. Julia Roberts, that's the one. Okay, next. This person is dead. He died in December 1980. He was a musician. So he used to play instruments like piano, the guitar. Yeah, that's John Lennon. Okay. That was too easy. Wait. Okay. Next person. This man died in 1977. He had, well, the first song, his first song and very famous song was Heartbreak Hotel. He was married with Priscilla, who was his wife.
Elvis Presley.
Yeah, very good. Oh my God, you know a lot about them. Yes, that's Presley. Nice, excellent. Okay, let me go with next person. Okay, this person died in 1997 too. She was very famous. She had two babies. And she was famous because she participated in health programs, helping people who were in poverty, traveling around the world. And she participated in charity events. And yeah, she was so beautiful.
Marilyn Monroe.
Diana.
Yeah, that was Diana. Yeah, that was Diana. Okay, that was Princess Diana. And let me go with the list. This person is so famous, but not because he was handsome or anything, but because he was considered a genius. When he was very young, he was not so smart. Yeah, that was Albert Einstein. That was good. Now, guys, hey, you're really good at this. Okay, nos hacen falta. We are missing Michael Jackson. We are missing, let me see who else. We are also missing Maria Teresa, right, de Calcuta, and Marilyn Monroe. Okay, what can you tell me about these people? Okay, tell me something about Michael Jackson. Algo que sepan, something that you know about Michael Jackson.
He was a singer.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
He was a good dancer.
Mm-hmm. He was a singer and dancer, yes.
Black.
He has a black person.
He's okay. The king of pop.
Oh.
And then he changed your
his skin tone.
Skin tone.
Michael Jackson polemic.
He was polemic. Yeah, he was a very very polemic person. Moses mentioned that he was considered the king of the pop. Now I got a question for you. ¿Todavía se considera el king o hay alguien más?
No.
He's the king of pop, right? Todavía. He is. Okay, so he is the king of pop. Okay. Anything else? ¿Algo más que quieren agregar de Michael Jackson? Anything else?
No sé cómo se dice, murió, falleció el 25 de julio del 21, creo.
Oh my God. He died.
Del 2000, creo.
2009. 2009,
yes.
Mm-hmm.
He died.
Yes, él murió. ¿Y Oscar? Perdón, Carlos.
Michael Jackson was the first singer that made a video clip that more 6 minutes with the
Thriller, right?
Minute with the theatrical essence.
Are we talking about Thriller? And
I remember he gave the best concert in the Super Bowl in the 1993.
Oh, okay. I didn't know.
Es uno de los mejores shows de medio tiempo, el Super Bowl.
Uh-huh.
In the middle time.
Yes. Oh, really? Well,
millions of dollars for publicity.
Oh, okay. Well, something that I knew about Thriller was that Thriller was the most expensive clip. So it was like $1 million only for Thriller. I think, or millions, I don't remember. But it was considered one of the most expensive videos. Thank you guys, very nice. What about, ¿qué nos hace falta? Who are we missing? Let me check it out. We are missing Marilyn. What do you know about Marilyn? What have you heard about her?
Marilyn Monroe was a girl and with natural, beautiful.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
She don't have
surgeries.
No one operation.
So she didn't have any surgery. Les voy a escribir esa palabra. I'm going to write that word down. So that is surgeries, the cirugías. Okay, surgeries. She didn't have any surgery. ¿Qué más saben de Marilyn, guys? What do you know about her?
She was a model, an actress, and singer.
Nice, nice.
Beautiful, Marilyn Monroe.
She was beautiful. Okay, like yes, she was beautiful. A natural beauty.
Yes.
She had portada in Playboy.
Yes.
Oh, really? The front page.
In that time was the more value of Playboy.
Oh, the most expensive face or person.
Yes.
Oh, I didn't know. Wow, you come to know a lot about people. Okay, interesting. Okay, guys, let's do the following before we move on. I want you to select una persona que ya haya fallecido, you know, somebody who is not alive anymore, somebody del que sepan bastante, you know, a lot of information, because de lo que logro escuchar, saben bastante. Escuché más chicas, well, escuché más chicos que chicas, so I don't know. Let me just check it out. I'm going to give you like three minutes maximum. I'm going to give you 3 minutes para que piensen en alguien, revisen rapidito some information about that person, y luego vamos a adivinar a quién escogieron. We are going to guess who you selected. Tienen 3 minutitos. You got 3 minutes. Alguien que esté, que no esté alive, right? Somebody who's dead. One more minute. Everybody, time is over. So let us listen to the description that you have preferred. Okay, so I haven't heard girls that much. So let me listen to some girls. Hello, girls.
Hi, Miss.
Hello, Renee.
Come on. Okay, let me just check it out. I know that Mabel is on her way. Well, let me start with Clary. Hello, Clary. Tell us your description. What do you have?
Hello, Miss.
Hello. Hola, Clary.
I'm not ready, Miss.
Oh, okay. I'll come back to you. No worries. I'll go with somebody else. Ya regreso. I'll come back to you. Jocelyn, are you ready? Or Jackie, are you ready, Jackie?
Miss.
Hello.
Solo voy a decir una frase y creo que ahí van a adivinar.
No, hágalo difícil, Miss. Make it difficult. Make it difficult. You can give us some information about the person before. But you can start. Si ya tienes something ready, so you can help us with it. También veo Anita. Sure. I see Brenda, yes?
No sé. No veo lo que está compartiendo o dejo de compartir, perdón.
Pues estoy compartiendo, pero no se, sí, no logran ver.
Se ve. Se ve.
Sí, se ve.
Sí. Oh, ok, oh. Thank you.
Permítame, voy a salir y voy a entrar, que soy desde el móvil.
Pero si sale del teléfono, it's fine, solamente deslice.
O sea que sí me aparece, pero todo distorsionado, así como, no sé. Es que tenía bloqueado el teléfono, porque estaba haciendo una cosa y ahorita se ve distorsionado todo. Todo.
Wait, intenté ahora, give it a try now.
No.
Bueno, de hecho, yo también estoy viendo el teléfono porque conecto ambos, pero sí, me parece. O simplemente intente, salga a otra pantalla y luego vuelva. So probably se le modificó or something.
Ok.
Uh-huh. Ok, so girls, any girl que quiera representar, girls, ¿quién nos quiere representar? I need a girl. Okay, Karina, thank you. Okay, represéntanos, please. Okay.
Okay.
Make it difficult.
I
I don't say the name, right?
Yeah, no, don't say the name of the person, just describe the person. Mm-hmm.
Okay. Okay. She was a singer. In 1995, she was a singer, like a country, and she made a one lyric in English too. Mm-hmm. She was born in United States, in Corpus Christi.
Elena.
Selena. No, are you talking about Selena?
Selena Quintanilla.
Gómez Quintanilla.
No, wait, Selena Gómez is one.
Selena Quintanilla. No, Selena Quintanilla. Selena Quintanilla.
Selena Gómez live.
But you're beautiful talking about Quintanilla.
Beautiful.
Yes.
How did you know? It was really hard for me to know. I had to listen to Le Cucaracha or something like that to guess correctly. thank you. Wow, you made it difficult, but aún así lo adivinaron. I don't know how. Okay, yeah. Go, Brian, go.
Okay, there's a little ball, a player who was born in Argentina. He was considered the best player in history. He was world champion.
Maradona.
He was a famous goal por la mano de Dios que I don't know. I don't
Maradona.
Quería llegar hasta ahí.
Yeah, well, they got it. Exactamente así me sentí, like, what? They already got it. Okay, next person. ¿Quién tiene otra? Who has another one? Who's ready?
Hi.
Okay, perfect. Go, Carlos.
Okay. This person born in USA. He has, he had an enterprise with millions. He was a founder of Apple, and he was a CEO of the same company, and he's actionist of Walt Disney.
Okay.
Steve Jobs.
Yes, Steve Jobs.
Okay, wow, you're really good. Guys, something that I noticed is muy buen listening, very good listening. Cool, I like it. All right, anybody else? Who is ready?
I miss.
Okay, perfect, Guadalupe, shoot it.
Okay, she was from Cuba. Mm-hmm. She was the black skin. Mm-hmm. She was singer. Mm-hmm. She died in July 16, 2003. Mm-hmm. And she was married. She called her husband Little Hat of Cotton.
Karina is raising her hand. I have an idea who she is, but I'm not sure. Karina, who is it?
Celia Cruz.
Yes.
Yeah, I was expecting for you to say azúcar. Okay, beautiful description. That was nice. Cool. All right, who's next? Who's ready?
It's difficult.
I heard very, Moses.
Very difficult. Ah, okay, Moses.
Let's go with Moses and then we go with Dennis.
Yeah.
Chicas, can you do me a favor? ¿Alguien tiene el enlace de la clase a la mano? ¿Pueden enviarla al grupo, please? Can you send it to the group?
¿El enlace?
Yeah, I don't find it.
¿El enlace? Ahorita, permítame.
Oh, I got it. Thank you. Es que Ignacio está is asking for that. Okay.
Feliz viernes.
No, but okay, I got it for him. ¿Quién más me falta? I'm missing somebody. Alex ya está acá. Wait, I'm just going to make a commercial here. Oh, okay, thank you, Alex. Alex. Creo que estamos todos. I hope. Okay. Okay, I'm gonna check in a second. Okay, I'm sorry. Moses, please go ahead.
Okay, chat. This person died in the helicopter accident in which the NBA legend, his daughter, and seven other people died.
Brian.
1 year ago, exactly, Kobe Bryant.
Brian.
Oh, yeah. Oh, Kobe my Bryant. God. It's Kobe true.
He was La Mamba Negra.
Kobe Bryant.
Almost a year ago, yes, right? Hace casi un año. Almost Mamba. A year ago. Wow.
Yes.
Okay, no. Time flies.
Good basketballista.
He was a good basketball player. All right. Yes. So thank you. Thank you for that. Dennis, I'm missing you. Go ahead, Dennis.
Okay. Is a person very important? Is difficult. Mm-hmm. Better now as he a British singer, music producer, fencer, the businessman. Mm-hmm. Writer, historian, and pilot. He is a famous for behind the vocalist, frontman, and co-songwriter for the heavy metal.
Oh my God.
Heavy metal band. He is considered by many singing expert, media, and general public has all the best singer.
In the story is her name the band?
Why?
The name is her of the band?
The band?
The vocalist. Or name the band?
Miss Manson.
No.
But you said that he was a producer, he was a vocalist, a frontman.
Vocalist?
And he was a businessman.
Brian Johnson?
Brian Johnson? No.
Brian Johnson?
No.
Trevor. Trevor.
Why?
Moses says Trevor, I think.
No. He's a pilot.
Wait, from Aerosmith.
No.
Iron Maiden.
Iron Maiden?
Iron Maiden, Bruce Dickinson. His pilot is Dickinson, yeah.
Oh, yes. Wait, was he a doctor too?
His doctor.
Yeah, right.
Intermediate level on guitar and piano. He's, ¿cómo se dice, astronauta?
No, an astronaut?
Yes, an astronaut, the master of leather.
Esgrimista.
Yeah.
What? Okay, I mean, I heard some years ago that there was a person who was so complete, que no solamente era como, people say bad things about rock and heavy metal.
No.
Pero era como fuera el estereotipo. He was like a role model. Era como un ejemplo a seguir, but I didn't know. No, nunca supe quién era. So what is the name of the person you said?
Bruce Dickinson.
Bruce Dickinson. Okay. Bruce Dickinson. So I heard that he was a pilot and a doctor. So I was like, wow. Okay, that's amazing. Especialmente he could play a lot of instruments, you know. Y uno a veces, ni uno. Okay, but that, wow, that's amazing. Okay, thank you for that. Anybody else? Girls? I think I'm missing some girls still, some boys. Norbert, no lo he escuchado porque viene tan callado, Norbert.
Excuse me.
Pedrina, hello. ¿Ready, Pedrina?
De la madre Teresa voy a hablar a alguien.
Pero no nos diga. No nos diga quién es. No, just no, tell
no, us. No, pero no lo voy a decir. Tal vez me entienden.
Dele, go for it.
Mother Teresa is an example.
Deme un segundo. Creo que alguien me dejó abierto el micrófono. And I hear a little dog. Tell us, Pedrina.
Ok. Teresa is her was her. ¿Me escuchó?
Yeah, I'm sorry, but había un poquito de interferencia. So, Teresa was?
Dice, Teresa es un ejemplo a tu follón. She was a server on Oswood Brooks. Her was her.
Her heart was to help?
La madre de Teresa.
Ajá, sí, o sea, sí, la madre de Teresa.
She was an example to follow, you
ajá,
said.
Sí, exacto, exacto. Uh-huh. Sí, sí.
Okay, so she was an example to follow. She was a heart, like a heart.
A her was her. Uh-huh. A seguir, es un ejemplo a seguir.
Uh-huh. Yeah, she was an example to follow. Uh-huh. Sí. Okay. What else? What else can you tell us about Teresa? ¿Qué más nos quiere contar de ella? What else?
Pues para I mean, un gran mother, una gran madre. Mm-hmm. Ay, que no sé cómo se dice en lo que es la iglesia, no sé cómo decirlo.
In the church? So he was an example in the church?
Es un ejemplo in the church.
Mm-hmm.
Para todos los católicos.
Mm-hmm. For Catholic.
Mm-hmm, for Catholic.
Okay, okay. Thank you, Pedrina. Very good. Thanks a lot for that. Okay. Thank you. Who wants to go next? ¿Quién está listo? Who wants to go next?
Okay, teacher.
Go, Richard. Go.
Okay. Brown. Zanzibar. One never name for six. London. One never. Never one vocalist, music, mm-hmm. and compositor who was now international mm-hmm. as they from of a big rock band that's enjoyed the overing me. She said during the 70s, ¿cómo sería?
In the 70s?
In 70s and 80.
I'm sorry, 70s and 80s.
70s and 80s, taking over from a mythic group like the Beatles and the Rolling Stones.
Oh.
So, I'm sorry, just to confirm. So this person that you're talking about was what specific was his job? What was his job?
Music, vocalist, and composition.
Okay, so he was a composer and a vocalist. He was a frontman for yes. Beatles and for Rolling Stones.
Yes.
Oh my God, I don't know.
Saving 70s and 80s.
So in the 70s and 80s.
Yes.
Okay, so he was a singer.
Yes.
Guys, do you know anything about Rolling Stones and
the person national?
Sorry?
The person is national?
International.
Oh.
Where was he from? What country was he from?
No.
Richard?
Sí, yes.
Where was the person from?
¿Dónde nació?
Uh-huh.
Zanzibar.
Oh, the person was Salvadorian.
No, no.
Mick Jagger.
London.
Mick Jagger?
No.
No?
No.
So hey, Richard?
Perdón?
Hey, Richard?
No.
Zanzibar.
No.
When you said Zanzibar, I thought you were talking about El San Salvador.
No.
So Zanzibar.
Zanzibar con Z.
Oh.
Yes, London.
Okay, so that was London.
It's Lennon.
Huh?
It's Lennon.
No.
No. It said that in the Beatles and in the Rolling Stones. To be honest, I don't know.
Yes.
Guys, does anybody know?
Yes, good vocalist, good music, good composition.
You have.
Pero no es Elton Jones, right?
No.
No idea.
No.
Then give us the answer. Who is the person?
Paul McCartney?
No.
Okay.
Preston?
No. He has every perfect voices.
Voices. Okay, no voices. Idea. No, who was the person? Mercury?
No.
Perdón.
¿Quién era? Who was it?
El mítico Freddie Mercury.
Ah, Freddie Mercury.
Yes.
The thing is that you mentioned Paul McCartney. So.
The Queen.
No Beatles, no Rolling Stones.
Yes.
Did he sing with the Beatles and the Rolling Stones?
Yes. Yes.
No.
Dice, bueno, la película medio me recuerdo. Nace en el 1946. ¿Verdad? Vocalista, músico, compositor.
He's a composer. Uh-huh.
Yes, composer, líder de Queen. Gozó de un éxito muy grande en los 70s, 80s. Yeah.
But I'm not sure. Creería que los Rolling Stones and the other group fueron de antes. They were
fue como una, por decirlo así, como una inspiration.
They were the inspiration.
Yes, pero sí, se relacionó con ellos porque como fue del mismo tiempo.
Yeah, they were their inspiration, but he didn't sing with them. Okay, got it. Yeah, I was like, what?
Yeah.
Okay, thank you for that. Clary, ¿está lista? Are you ready? Or alguien más? Anybody else? Do we have one more person?
Me, teacher.
Yes, Norbert, go.
Okay, she is a woman singer.
Mm-hmm.
He's began your career in 23 mm-hmm. year old. In 2005, released her debut album music. Mm-hmm. Your first name is Robin.
It's a girl or a boy?
It's woman.
It's a woman.
Yeah.
So she is a singer, you said?
Yes.
And she released her first album in 2003? 2005.
Yeah.
Okay. When was she born?
The born.
Mm-hmm. When was she born? ¿Cuándo nació? When was she born?
February 1988. Yeah.
1988. Okay, guys, listen up. The person was born in 1988, and she released her first album in 2005. Who is that person? Britney Spears? Norbert, is that Britney?
No.
Okay, 1980.
It's very famous.
Cristina Carlosa? Cristina Aguilera?
No.
Oh my god.
Ah. No.
Oh, wait. Where is she from? Where is she from?
She's died or alive.
Oh, that's a good question. Is she alive?
Is that,
¿Está viva? ¿Is she alive?
Yes.
She is alive.
Yes.
Todavía está viva, he said.
¿She is a Sia?
No.
Where is the person from? Where is she from?
A country, yeah.
What country, Norbert? Where is she from?
Um,
Is she from USA?
Excuse me, is the is the national nationalidad?
Nationality, she is from
Barbados.
Oh my god. From Barbados. What? I know. Rihanna?
Rihanna.
Yeah.
Oh. Okay, yeah. I was from Barbados. I was like, she's wait. Woman. She's the only one I know. Okay. Thank you. Oh, yeah. Es que nos faltó la canción. So we were missing the name of the song. Yeah. She has good music.
Yo que canto un pedacito, yo pues.
¿Quién va a cantar? Brian va a cantar un pedazo de Umbrella.
No, René se puede hacer chaquillo, pero que no está.
Cuando salga, ojalá que salga temprano en nos cante un pedacito de Shakira en English. El waka waka, aunque sea. Okay. Okay, guys. Nice. Guys, that was amazing. So, muy buen listening. I mean, I heard you. Siguiendo lo que los compañeros iban diciendo, so very good job on that, that was good. Let's continue because tenemos dos actividades más y luego también tenemos la presentación de ustedes que son 1:30, 2 minutes, right?
No.
Espero que podamos escucharlos a todos because that is the idea. A las 9, permítanme, a las 9 tenemos la revisión. En un par de minutos vamos a tener la revisión también de la encuesta de calidad. Con los compañeros. Dame un segundo.
No, el minuto 30 era un tema libre, no era algo en específico.
No, dijimos que siempre cuando fuera en pasado, you're good. Pueden contarnos una historia, you can tell us a story, pueden contarnos una película, you know, whatever. Siempre cuando la contemos and we use it in past, estamos súper bien. Dame un segundito. Deme just a second, solo quiero confirmar la hora. Es a las 9:20. Oh, okay, tenemos un par de minutos entonces. Okay, guys, so let's go. Here we have read the following invitation letter for a training and answer the following questions. Vamos a terminar un par de ejercicios del manual para que luego ya nos quedemos listos para escucharlos. Primero, como hemos hecho anteriormente, no vamos a leer la tarjeta. We are not going to read this invitation because vamos a enfocarnos en las preguntas. So let's take a look at question number one. How often does the training take place? Leamos la pregunta y luego vamos rapidito al texto y busquemos la respuesta. How often does the training take place? Guys, can you give me the answer for this? Ahora sí, leamos rapidito. Read this super quick. How often? ¿Qué tan a menudo does this training take place? Once a year, once a month, every day, every week? Está en la primera línea, it's in the first line.
Annual?
Annual. Yes, exactly, annual, so. Eso sería una vez al año, once a year,
once a year.
Mm-hmm. So annual. Yes. Number two, when is the training taking place? ¿Cuándo va a tener lugar? ¿Cuándo se va a llevar a cabo? When is the training taking place?
April 4th.
Very good.
Number
three, who is conducting the workshop? Who?
Professional speaker.
A professional speaker. Yes. Very good. Number four. What is the topic for the training held this year?
Conflict resolution.
Excellent. Conflict resolution. Number five, what is the request made at the end of the letter? Remember, request es solicitud. What is the request made at the end of the letter? ¿Cuál es la solicitud? Algo que le digan, hágalo, esperamos esto, you know. What is the
confirm
request?
Confirm to attendance.
Exactly, confirm, que les confirmen. So please confirm. That is the request made of the letter. Oh, you see, super fácil, easy. So from now on, guys, siempre que tengan lecturas, apliquen esas técnicas de lectura. No se vayan a leerlo todo y luego vayan para las preguntas. That doesn't work. Vamos primero a ver qué es lo que me piden, qué tipo de información requiero y luego voy a leerlo rapidito. No necesitamos leer todo para encontrar la respuesta. Eso es comprensión lectora. Now, let's move on a little bit. Vamos a repasar solamente un poquito los pasados para que ya nos quedemos listos para la speaking part. Number one, it says here, practice the past form of the irregular verbs and then check the answers with a classmate. Ya sé que son pro con esos verbos, no les va a costar or anything. So ayúdenme de una sola vez with the verbs in past. What is the past of meet?
Met.
Mm-hmm. Met, exactly. ¿Qué, me pueden dar un ejemplo? Can you give me an example using met?
I met with my friends yesterday.
Mm-hmm. I met my friends. Yes, excellent. ¿Alguien más? ¿Anybody else?
Creo la sopa, bueno.
Hola, Ignacio.
Hi, hi, teacher.
Hi. Sorry, ya escuché lo de la sopa. It's okay. Thank you so much for joining. No worries. That's okay. Okay, so met. ¿Alguien me da un ejemplo con el pasado de meet, pero negativo? Can you help me with the past? But in negative, utilizando... Gracias. Oh, okay. El pasado de meet. Como yo no conocí. Can anybody give me an example?
I didn't meet the girlfriend of Renee.
Okay, super bien. I didn't meet. That's good. Now let's go with have. What is the past of have?
Past of have.
Have. Sí, aquí sí solamente aplica have. Exactly, have. Mm-hmm. Yes. Has sería presente. Have es pasado súper bien. Speak. What is the past of speak?
Okay.
Spoke.
Mm-hmm. Spoke. Go.
Gosh.
Mm-hmm. When.
When.
When. Perfect.
Wow, sorry.
Do. Do.
Do.
Did.
Did. Yes. Right.
Wrote.
Okay. Now, repitamos esto. Write sin la doble R. El pasado lleva doble R, pero no se pronuncia. So, write, wrote.
Write, wrote.
Write, wrote.
Exacto. Wrote. Wrote. That's it. Okay. Send.
Send.
Send. Send. Very good. Yes. Send. Read. ¿Cuál es el pasado de read?
Read.
Very good. See?
So.
So.
So. So and run?
Run.
Run.
Run and run, exactly. Very good, guys. Now, vamos con el ejemplo número 2, exercise number 2. Use the past of be. Ahora sí, solamente es el pasado de be to create sentences and or questions. For example, number 2 es una pregunta, number 3 and 4. 5 and 6 son preguntas, right? So, déjame un segundito. Le voy a mutear un momentito, Ignacio. So, let's take a look at them. ¿Cómo puedo crear oraciones y preguntas en pasado con el verbo be? Number 1, I be at the cinema last night. ¿Cómo la puedo convertir en oración? How can I make a question or sentence?
I was at the cinema last night.
Very good. I was at the cinema last night. Exactly. Now, number 2, esta sí es pregunta. So, remember, preguntas con el verbo be, va el verbo be primero. ¿Cómo podemos hacer la número 2? How can you make number 2?
Were we in a coffee when you called?
Super bien. Were we in a cafe. Uh-huh. Yes. Thank you. That's nice. What about number 3?
Was I late?
Was I late?
Esa es una posibilidad. Exactly. Was I late?
Were you late?
Oh, esta sería otra. Were you late? Exactly. A la primera, was I late? Es como cuando yo llego a un lugar, me están esperando y les pregunto, llego muy tarde. Ok. Y ya pasó una hora. So, was I too late? Ok. Or were you late? So, realmente depende de cuál es el contexto. Number four. Siempre seguimos con preguntas. ¿Cuál sería la número cuatro? What would be number four? Estamos
con el verbo be. Were late for the interview. Late for the interview.
Excellent. Were they late? Uh-huh. Were they late for the interview? Yeah. Good. Number five. Who has number five? Como cuando se viene y le pregunta, no me recuerdo cómo se llama. ¿Cuál era su nombre?
What was?
Mm-hmm. Excellent. What was his name? Mm-hmm. Le agregamos a veces la palabra again como para preguntar, dígame su nombre otra vez. What was his name again? What was her name again? What was your name again? So, utilizamos esto para las preguntas. Cuando no me recuerdo. So, what was your name? What was his name? What was her name? Mm-hmm. Very good. Amazing, guys. Y la número seis. What is the one in number six?
Why were you late?
Why were you late? Exactly. Why were you late? Guys, amazing. Super bien con grammar. Super bien con speaking and listening. Oh my God, I'm super amazed today. Okay, that was really good. I have just one more y luego ya nos vamos a la parte de speaking para que empecemos a avanzar con el tiempo too, para que luego tengamos la encuesta de Instagram. So take a look at the following. This is, okay, this is a little story. Go over it and fill in the blanks with the right words from the box below. Hay una historia pequeñita acá, pero le hacen falta algunas letras. We are missing some words. Not letters, but words. We have excited and children about walked, where, started, not parked in autumn. ¿Saben el significado de autumn? Do you remember the meaning of autumn?
No, me.
Creo que alguien lo dijo por ahí.
¿Otoño?
Otoño, correcto. So fall or autumn. Uh-huh. Es otoño. So here, vamos a completar la historia. We are going to be completing this story con las palabras que tenemos in red to make it, you know, make sense, right? So it can make sense. For example, la primera dice one excited evening. One children evening. So, ¿qué palabra puedo utilizar acá? What word do you think we can use right here?
Started.
Para hacerlo más fácil, to make it easier, recordemos que tenemos como sujeto, verbo, complemento, right? So, that is the idea in general. So, si no encontramos qué utilizar, pues sigamos, we can continue. For example, tenemos el primer espacio, it says here.
Well,
okay.
Evening.
Evening.
No, where evening.
One where evening. Solo que started and were ambos son verbos y acá dice one tendría que ser un sujeto pero no tiene mucho sentido. One es como uno, right? Mm-hmm. Norbert, can you repeat?
Children, miss.
One children evening, pero leamos la idea completa ahora. One children evening.
No.
Evening es como la noche, right? Okay. Tiene algo que vamos a encontrar. Tenemos que encontrar algo con evening. But sigamos, claro. No se preocupen, sigamos. And then we can come together here. Remember, son sujeto verbo para que tenga lógica here. It dice, Charles and Beth went to the theater. They attended a play. A play es como una obra teatral. No es un juego, es una obra teatral. So they attended a play. They play
Started.
Oh, acá sí yes. podemos usar started.
Yes.
Okay, I'm gonna write it down. Y si no, luego la corregimos, no hay ningún problema. So we can modify okay. this as much as possible. So the play started. Ah, the play, sujeto y verbo. The play started yeah. at 7. Charles and Beth enjoyed the theater. ¿Quién me ayuda a leer? Who wants to read?
Yes, after the play, Charles and Beth worked together in the
park.
Why not? That makes sense. Okay. Mm-hmm.
Day by side, the lake.
Mm-hmm.
The moon was bright. They talked.
Deme un segundo. Give me just a second. Me comí un espacio. Wait. Hold on. Me comí un espacio here. I was super hungry. wait. Ahora sí. Okay. Beside the lake.
Beside the lake.
They?
What?
That could be, okay. Yeah, that could bro. Definitely be, okay. I'm gonna write it down, y si necesitamos cambiarlo luego, no hay problema. So, they walked beside the lake. Mm-hmm. Beside Continue, the... please, Dennis.
The moon was bright.
Bright. Mm-hmm.
Bright. They took it.
About.
About. Good. They talk about. Mm-hmm.
Talk about.
The future. Okay.
Their fear.
Super bien.
That went how? Their children were not.
Okay, that makes sense.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
No asleep. No sleep. They wired for Charlie's bed to return. They were
exciting.
Exciting?
Mm-hmm. They were excited, you said? Okay.
Yes.
Excited. Okay.
Charles told the
mountain.
It's a stole, como les dijo, uh-huh. pero ¿a quién les dijo? So, child stole.
The children.
Oh, the children, okay. Mm-hmm. So, told the children, uh-huh. Told the children about the play. Mm-hmm.
Then bed put children to bed.
Mm-hmm.
Charlie's in bed.
Where?
Very tired. Yeah. Good. Ahora sí, we're very tired. It was a good night. Pero nos yes. falta una palabra. ¿Cuál One. Es la palabra que falta?
After.
After.
Exactly. So autumn. We are missing autumn. Yes. So one autumn evening. ¿A qué se refiere con one autumn evening? A una noche de...
De otoño.
De otoño, exactly. One autumn evening. Yes. Okay, guys. Very good job with this. That was nice, nice, nice. Okay. So now I think we are just ready for this. Previously, yesterday, les pedía que hicieran la preparación de esta historia. You know, today we just got it ready. And, uy, dejé de compartirles, denme un segundo, give me just a second. Tenemos 10 minutos antes de tomar la encuesta para que podamos comenzar. And si tengo compañeros que ya estén listos, ya salimos de eso, you know, and you can tell us the story. So, do I have any volunteer? ¿Tengo algún voluntario? Lo que vamos a hacer, it says here, present to the class your short story. And the best of luck. So vamos a presentar cualquier historia que tengamos lista. No es necesario que sea like from the topic or anything de lo que vimos ayer or answering any question. Siempre cuando sea en pasado estamos súper bien. So we are super, super good. ¿Voluntarios?
Hi, teacher.
Okay, perfect, Richard.
No, so let me... ¿Sí?
Dígame.
No, dígame.
Solo deme un segundo. Voy a timearla, le voy a poner el tiempo porque si no, no vamos a lograr escucharlos a todos.
Pero no es muy largo. Ya no se le ha terminado.
Vaya, no, dejémosle en 1:30. Let's leave it in 1:30. That's okay.
No sé si voy a llegar
it's
a eso.
Hello and bye bye.
No, tampoco, hello, yes, por eso yes. Les dije, por eso les dije 2 minutos, pensando que si no me van a decir hello and thank you.
Hello, bye, good evening.
Ajá, no. Okay, I mean, lo poquito que podamos decir es bienvenido, that's super welcome, no se preocupe. I'm gonna time it, por si acaso, just in case. Vaya. Go, Richard, go.
Okay. Hello, my mother get... me a scrap for my bright eye. I summer I had it above which a teaching have a snack snake, creo que se dice snake. Wall you say it net went looking for me soccer ball. Really see that he was going to tag the box. Oh, to the gram where we have summoned flower and open feel to release the snake in his habitat no, es que no era. That's it, teacher.
Actually, time ya is
no,
over.
Ya no remember.
And time is over. So just to confirm, let me confirm the story. You were talking about a snake, right?
Yes.
So at the end of the story, you released the snake to the habitat.
Yes.
Okay. So you found the snake in a box?
Yes.
Okay. Did you make up the story? ¿La creó or was it for real?
Sí, yes, created fue unas imágenes que usted
nos
compartió,
okay.
Pero solo tenía la idea, entonces me comencé a remember y medio me acordé.
No, but you did it nicely. You did it nicely. Solamente una palabrita here, se la voy a escribir en the chat. Okay. Is some.
Some. Y la, y la palabra de serpiente es snake.
Snake.
Snake. Snake.
Snake. Ajá. So snake. Some. Okay. Sin la some. E, solo some. And some. Snake.
Snake.
Yes. Okay. Thank you, Richard. Very good job. Guys, the emojis are Richard. You know, he decided to break the ice. And he was the first. Thank you. Yeah. Next person. ¿Quién va siguiente, guys? Tenemos still tiempo para dos más, I believe.
Mi teacher.
Más. Yes, Mabel. Amazing. 1:30. Okay. 1:30. Go.
Okay. My story is about my pet Ducky. Ducky was a boxer dog. She was adopted by my family when she was about 3 months old. She lived on the street and was very, how do you say, desnutrida o descuidada.
She had bad nutrition.
Bad nutrition. Bad nutrition.
Malnutrition.
but she improved little by little with our care and the help of the veterinarian.
The vet.
The vet. She was always very playful, loving, and hyperactive.
Playful?
Playful, yes. He was with us for 13 years until he died of illness.
Okay.
It was very doloroso, it's painful.
Painful, yeah.
Painful, and today we have not had another pet.
Oh, I'm sorry to hear about it. But even though fue un poquito painful, me alegra mucho que, you know, que tuvieron el corazón de adoptarla, to adopt the pet, you know, that's amazing. That was a beautiful story.
Y ella se lo llevó porque ya nadie en mi familia, ni mi papá, ni mi hermano, ni yo hemos querido tener otra.
Por el mismo sentimiento, I imagine, sí, because no it was nada. Difficult. Yeah, I totally understand you because my sister has a dog. Y tiene 11 años. The dog is 11 years old y ya tiene como problemas en la espalda. Ay. So, ya tiene reuma. So, yeah, we are like, oh, no, that's going to be painful. Okay, yeah. But thank you for sharing the story. It's muy bonita. That's a beautiful story. I liked it. Nice. Guys, tenemos uno más. Time for one more y luego después vamos a pasar los demás. Who goes next? Yes, Carlos. Perfect.
Carlos.
Oh, I'm sorry, Dennis. Yeah, please, after. You can go after. Mm-hmm. Vamos, Dennis. I mean, Carlos.
Okay. I speak about of the movie Space Jam 2. The last Saturday, I saw this movie with my dogger. Yes. With my dogger. Yes, dogger. And the movie is about a rabbit. Rabbit Bugs Bunny. And one player of NBA. And they need to save the world of a game. It's a history very enjoy and with my dogger enjoy the movie and drink soda eating ¿cómo se llama?
snacks
really and was a happy after.
Okay, nice. Well, Carlos, I'm happy to hear that you enjoyed the time with your daughter because that's important. And time is over, actually. Okay, super bien. Very nice description. Muy buen orden, you know, very good order. That was super, super good. Okay, guys, I have to stop you just for a minute. Yo sé que todos quieren pasar ahorita. I'm just kidding. No, I know that we really want to listen to you. But in the meantime, tenemos algo importante que hacer. So we are going to take just right now some minutes para poder completarlo. Necesito su enorme ayuda para que podamos completar la encuesta ya de calidad del survey que nos piden Safford. Les voy a compartir los links y les voy a compartir también un poquito de los pasos. So please guys, no, a mí se me pueden adelantar, pero no tanto, right? Let's do it together porque Safford no está permitiendo ahorita ningún error. Entonces, si no les puede afectar, remember that la encuesta es como su backup para decir, ya terminé el compromiso que tengo con ustedes, right? Les voy a compartir ahorita el link para que vayamos como todos juntos. So we can go here together. Les voy a ir presentando pantalla. So, ¿les funciona mejor acá o les funciona en WhatsApp? Where is it better for you?
Acá, en mi caso.
En el chat, teacher, en el chat.
¿En el chat de aquí o en el chat de WhatsApp? De aquí, teacher. Ah, vale. Súper bien, entonces. Okay. ¿Todos estamos bien? ¿Se los presento solo acá? ¿O se los mando WhatsApp, too?
No. No worries.
Okay. I mean, just for you to have the info. Okay, bye. Solo les comparto then. Un segundo. Okay. Y les voy a compartir mi pantalla. Let me share my screen. Espero que todos la logren ver. Les acabo de compartir el link para la encuesta de satisfacción. So, ya lo hemos hecho antes. A mí es el mismo proceso. Solamente, please, no se vayan a adelantar o pongamos una fecha que no es. You know? Seamos súper, súper careful con las fechas, please. So, inicia acá con el número completo de la orden de inicio sin guiones. Esas se las voy a copiar y pegar. Para que no tengan mayor dificultad y solamente sea como un copy paste. So, give me one second. Acá se las copio. Ese es el orden de gestión. Lo que vamos a hacer es solamente.
Pegar.
Sorry, I got the flu. Yeah, solamente copiar y pegar. So, copiamos esta que les acabo de poner ahí. Sorry. Okay. El nombre completo. En el nombre completo, guys, les pido que escribamos su nombre tal cual aparece en el DUI. So, en mi caso es como like my full name. So, I go like Julia. Si tienen apellido de casado o casados, no tienen el D. Pero sí, you know, if you are a girl and you're married, so if tienen el D, pues pónganle, please. So in my
teacher.
Hola.
El número ese de gestión, tal cual lo copiamos con guiones y la pleca, ¿verdad?
Exactamente como se los puse. Solo cópialo y pégalo para que no vayamos a tener un error de dedo. Se lo pongo en WhatsApp.
El enlace de la encuesta, teacher.
Sí, por supuesto, se lo comparto acá. Se lo voy a poner en el chat nuevamente, este de acá. Me confirma si le funciona.
Sí, yo creo que ahorita se abrió.
Vale, súper bien. ¿Todos tienen acceso? ¿Does everybody have access? Ok. Entonces, el primer dato que vamos a poner dice ingrese el número completo de la orden. Es el que les acabo de copiar acá. Porfa, cópienlo y péguenlo. No lo vayan a escribir. Si lo necesitan en WhatsApp, les digo. Nombre completo es su nombre, right? Your full name. Nombre, apellido, así como aparece en el DUI, tal cual. Correo electrónico, de preferencia su correo electrónico personal, right? Si tienen alguno. Número de teléfono, again, es el suyo, esos datos son de ustedes. El número 5 dice sexo, solamente lo tienen que seleccionar y esto es todo. Acá son 2. Yo ya selecté. Y la número 6 dice departamento de residencia. Este es un drop-down menu, entonces acá ya está el menú, solo viene y selecciona de dónde son, ¿verdad? En mi caso, por ejemplo, La Libertad, porque acá yo soy de acá. En su caso, can be San Salvador. Norberto, no sé dónde, Norberto La Paz, ¿verdad?
Yes, teacher.
Norberto La Paz. Jackie, Aguachapán.
Autopista, mi sisa.
And there we go. Y el municipio de residencia, eso sí lo vamos a escribir. Me avisen todos cuando estamos ya en la número 8, cuando hemos avanzado hasta acá.
Don't
teach. Okay, perfect. Don't teach. si llegamos a la número 8, antes que se me olvide, solamente una cosita. Hay algunas personas que no van a realizar esta vez la encuesta por motivos administrativos, que creo que ya les habían comentado. So, en el caso de Brenda, Carlos, Claudia, esta vez no le estaríamos completando. Karina, no le estaríamos completando, así que no worries. Amén. Por favor, quédense con nosotros siempre. Stay with us. Solo no le vamos a enviar.
Ya no la continúo, Lick, porque yo la estaba haciendo.
Sí, perdón, se me fue por alto ese detallito. Pero no se preocupen. No, en su caso no es necesario. It is not necessary. Sí. So, estamos bien. Pero siempre quédense con nosotros, please. Stay with us until the end. Okay. Now, en el caso de la número 8, es la empresa donde trabaja. Recordemos que como empresa tenemos la razón social. En este punto acá, vamos a escribir la razón social de su empresa. No sé si alguien necesita la razón social, con gusto se la brindo. Quienes ya hemos hecho la encuesta anteriormente, pues ya tenemos el dato, ¿verdad? De cuál es la razón social de su empresa, pero si no, let me know y ahorita se las doy.
Solo quiero confirmar, ¿es Grupo Especializado de Asistencia, S.A. o es S.A.D.C.B.?
Grupo Especializado de Asistencia, El Salvador, S.A.D.C.B. Ajá, para los tres, ¿verdad? Bueno, para los cuatro, con Mabel. Uh-huh.
Ok, gracias.
Uh-huh. Ana Delmi, vamos con Servicios Integrales Consolidados, S.A.D.C.B. Para las tres, right? Para Jackie y también para Clary. Hola, Norbert.
En mi caso.
Aparece como Asociación Cooperativa de Ahorro y Crédito Comunal Agrícola.
Che, ¿puedes repetir? El...
Claro. Servicios Integrales Consolidados SADCB.
Thank you, teacher.
You're welcome. ¿Alguien más la necesita? ¿Todos saben cuál es la razón social de la de ustedes? Jocelyn, la suya sigue siendo Pedro Antonio Alemán Mengíbar, Librería Fénix.
Sí, teacher, ya la puse, gracias.
Uh-huh. Sí, dígame.
En la mía es Handworks SADCB.
Ahorita le confirmo, Guadalupe. Sí, correcto, Handworks SADCB. Uh-huh. En el caso de Dolores, Dolores Eduardo Nelson, la de ustedes se aparece como PDC Comercial El Salvador S.A.D.C.B. Déjenme ver.
Sí, teacher, más. Thank you.
You're welcome. Y los demás creo que ya somos, ¿verdad? Todos tienen ya el detalle, ya le completaron el nombre de la empresa. ¿Me falta alguien? Lo tomaré como un no. Ok, vamos con el nombre del proveedor. Este es un drop down menu, entonces vamos a tener que escogerlo. Si no lo seleccionan o no le dan como un punto afuera, un clic afuera, un tap afuera, les puede seleccionar otro, so please be careful. Van a escoger el que dice inglés corporativo, Regal International, SADCB. Le damos clic, si están en la computadora, un tap afuera, and be careful porque si no se les puede mover. So, porfa, solamente acá. Inglés corporativo. ¿Todos lo encontraron?
Yes.
No.
Bueno. Inglés corporativo está abajo de esta escuela interamericana. Está como en medio. Si se fija, está acá, como en medio.
Regal, ¿no? Regal International.
Inglés corporativo, Regal. This is Regal. Ok, vamos al nombre del curso. Con el nombre del curso, I'm going to be sharing this with you. Again, vamos a hacer un copy and paste. Se llama Inglés Principiante, módulo 6. Ya se los comparto. Es Inglés Principiante, módulo 6. Igual, como está bastante largo, Lo único que voy a hacer es copy and paste. I come and I write it down. En la número 11 dice valore los siguientes aspectos relacionados con el curso. Eso se, todo tiene que ver como con la estructura que INSAFOR ha decidido, right, para estos cursos de básico, intermedio y avanzado. El primero dice cómo considera el tiempo empleado para desarrollar el curso. Se refiere que, por ejemplo, módulo 1, módulo 2, etcétera, tardan 4 semanas, 2 horas, 4 semanas. ¿Cómo considera el curso? ¿Considera que es muy poquito tiempo? ¿O está bien? You know, what do you think? ¿Qué opina del contenido y estructura? Remember that todo está basado en el material de INSAFOR. Y la última, ¿qué opina de las opciones o herramientas tecnológicas para el curso que han sido la plataforma y las sesiones que hemos tenido en Zoom? So, seleccionan acá la que consideran ustedes más acorde, insuficiente, deficiente, aceptable, bueno o excelente. ¿Me confirman cuando ya estemos done, cuando ya están listos para la 12? Ok, perfecto. Vamos entonces, chicos, con las fechas. En las fechas, sí, porfa, be careful. Ok. Les voy a escribir las fechas acá.
¿Cómo?
Hola.
No,
teacher.
Dígame, Guadalupe.
A mí se me borró lo que había hecho. Me regresa al punto número 10, que es el nombre del curso.
El nombre del curso se lo comparto nuevamente, no hay problema. Es inglés principiante, módulo 6. Casa. Ok, con las fechas de inicio, si se fijan, hay un botoncito acá porque les va a pedir que seleccionen la fecha. Iniciamos el 19 de agosto, estamos en septiembre, solo nos vamos atrás y vamos a seleccionar 19 de agosto. Solamente le damos clic o un tap y eso sería todo. That would be it. Now, la fecha en la que finalizamos el calendario por lo general les da la fecha del día de ahora, que es 16 de septiembre. Solamente fíjense o pónganle atención que estamos agosto y septiembre. Iniciamos 19 de agosto, 19 del 8, terminamos 16 del 9. Algunas veces les aparece al revés, pero está súper bien.
Don, teacher.
Ok, gracias por la confirmación. Thank you so much for that. Now, en la 14 dice cuál es el nivel de satisfacción al completar el módulo.
Necesito, teacher, voy a volver a empezar.
Vaya, Alex, si necesita ayuda, let me know, me avisa. Con el grado de satisfacción, recordemos que para poder continuar el módulo intermedio, es necesario, ¿verdad?, que usted esté satisfecho con el módulo. En general, no se refiere a como a la satisfacción personal, sino el módulo en sí, ¿right? Seleccionamos en la número 14. Y luego la número 15 y la 16 son para ustedes. La 15 dice, menciona otros cursos de su interés. Si usted tiene otro curso en mente que le gustaría, como Excel o no sé, otra cosa, lo puede escribir acá y eso va directamente en INSAFOR. Y la número 16, que son los comentarios. Si tiene comentarios, retroalimentación, comentarios positivos, you know, algo de mejora, siéntanse toda libertad de escribirlo acá. Y antes que me le den clic a enviar, solamente recordándoles, cuando usted le da clic acá, le va a decir gracias. Necesito que me le tome siempre una captura de ese gracias con su nombre completo. Nos le envíen al grupo de WhatsApp, please. Solamente estoy pendiente con Guadalupe y con Alex. Si necesitan ayuda, me avisan, please, para regresar here. No se les olvide, porfa, tomarle captura. Okay. Ignacio, ¿todavía estamos en la fecha de inicio? I'm sorry, I got some flu. Okay. So Ignacio, si gusta me sigue acá. Let me just go back to la fecha de inicio, significa que estamos acá. En la número 12, Ignacio, vamos a escribir 19 de agosto. Y la fecha de finalización es la que nos da el calendario, que es ahora, 16 de septiembre. Luego, la 14 es el nivel de satisfacción. Esperamos que todo haya sido de su agrado durante el módulo. Seleccionamos la que usted considere más adecuada. Y las últimas dos, la 15 y la 16, son completamente suyas. A mí queda su criterio si tiene otro curso de interés o si tiene comentarios, retroalimentación, algo que nos quiera compartir, lo escribimos acá. Y cuando le dé clic en enviar, le toma captura, porfa. That's very important. Okay. Oh, amazing, guys. Okay. Veo la de Jocelyn, Jackie, Moses, Sonia, Dani, Dolores, René, Clary, Richard, Danis, Pedrina, Guadalupe. Marvin, me hace un favor, me escribe su nombre completo al pie de la paginita, porfa.
Ahorita.
No, pero espérame. El suyo creo que sí está bien. Creo que es el de Marvin López. Creería que es el de Marvin López, la que no lleva nombre. Porfa, para identificarlo precisamente.
Te pego.
Brian. Marvin Bonilla, gracias Ana. Marvin López, gracias Marvin. Me falta la de Nelson. Me falta la de Ernesto, creería. Perdón, Eduardo. Eduardo, me falta la suya. Gracias, Nelson. I see yours. So, missing Eduardo's. Ella me mandó la suya.
Ya la envié, teacher. Ya.
Let me just double check. Y ya seguimos, chicos. Give me one second here. Solo confirmo. Let me just check it out. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I'm just missing one. I'm just missing Eduardo. Okay, guys. So, no, Claudia, no se preocupe. No worries. Okay, so thanks a lot for that. We are just going to Ok. Oh, Ignacio, si ya la terminamos, ahorita que ya la terminemos, le da clic en enviar y al enviarla le va a decir gracias. Necesito que me le tome captura a gracias. Y me manda esa captura con su nombre completo. And that would be it. Okay. Now, guys, tenemos, we have here a little something. Nos quedamos pendientes mientras Ignacio nos envía la captura, que solamente creería que es el que estamos pendientes. Estamos here working un poquito con la parte de las presentations. Son 1:30. So, let's continue with this. Y estoy pendiente, Ignacio, me avisa si necesita, you know, some assistance here. So in the meantime, ¿quién quiere continuar? Who wants to continue? Solamente es 1:30, guys. 1:30, súper rápido. Historia,
pero no sé si va a durar el tiempo.
Dígale y no hay problema. Estoy ajustando el tiempo porque la idea es que escuchemos a todos. Si dura menos, no hay problema. Tampoco 10 segundos. No, no. Like, hello, good evening, bye-bye, right? No, vaya, go, Alex, no problem.
Vaya. Good night, hello, my friends. I want to tell you one history for my life in my family. When I was a little boy with my brother, I traveled every week for the Huasapa city. Every vacation, siempre. My grandfather had cows and my brother and me, we learned to take care of them. Small turkey, so that we could have dinner for them in the new year. There was a turkey that was bad and in follow use. It was of 2 years. In the year that we're going to have eve of dinner, I was be happy. I will eat and a turkey because one day before the new year. I could never. La cosa es que se lo robaron. Ya no me lo pude.
No, lo estaba haciendo súper bien. You were doing a good job. I was laughing because you said that the turkey was bad with you.
Era
and
malo,
you were happy malo. Because you were going to eat malo. It. No, pero estaba súper bien. Your story was good. But the turkey was stolen.
Sí, yes.
Se robaron el turkey.
Sí, el que lo criamos desde chiquito y cuando creció nos picaba a René y a mí. Y de contentos que lo íbamos a cenar y se lo roban un día antes.
I mean, I understood your story and that was super funny. Okay, no, but you did it nicely. Yes, Alex, very good. Good job, guys. Un clap for him. That was very nice. Thank you so much for that. Okay, next person. Y de hecho fue el tiempo. That was the time, Alex. Next person, ¿quién nos quiere contar una historia, guys?
Me, teacher.
Go, Dani, go. Dani, go.
Okay. 5 years had passed since the historic concert in the band Iron Maiden in the Salvador. Mm-hmm. As part of their tour, the Book of Soul, World Tour 2016, in which in invitation for two performing classic song, the band was their last work study in training the Book of Soul in the public could also enjoy the presentation on the Salvadorian Bank, Spider, in the
the other band in USA is the Raving Against the Machine in Anthrax, who had included almost month before the concert. That's it. Snoof.
Okay, thank you so much for your story about like the concert and those things, especially because some of us are not familiar with that. So thanks a lot for choosing that. Okay. All right, do we have more? I want to listen to some girls. Casi no escuchado chicas, solo I think I heard Sonia. I heard Mabel. Anybody else? Yes. Okay, Karine. I like it. But defiéndanos. Defend girls. Huh?
Teacher, other girl.
Oh, alguien más dijo me. Es que yo confundo su voz y la de Guadalupe, creo. ¿Verdad que usted dijo me, Guadalupe?
Yes.
You see, yeah, for some reason, la voz se parece un poquito. Okay, okay, Guadalupe, go for it, and luego Karina.
Okay. And I talk about the travel to Guatemala. I went to Guatemala City last month. We left the house around 5 in the morning and arrived to Guatemala 10:30. We both we went with my father-in-law. We both spare part for car. And I knew a little the capital. Also, I saw past the airplane because the airport is near the capital in Guatemala. And later, we went to Cayala Square. We took pictures. Nice. It's a nice place because it's similar to Italy. There is a monument of the man with the mirror body on the ground. After that, we returned to El Salvador, maybe around 1 p.m. Mm-hmm. And on the way, passed by McDonald's for lunch.
Oh, okay. Okay, actually, time is over. I have to stop you. I'm sorry about that, but that was a beautiful description. I like the way you included a lot of details. It was very organized. I really like it. That was nice. Incluyó muchos detalles that are lo hacen más, más vívido. So that was very good. And yeah, the place is amazing. Thank you so much for that. Karina, I heard you wanna represent women too. Let's do it. 1 minute 30, go.
Okay, I will talk about a little thing when I was start to practice wrestling. I was 9 years old and I was studying in 5th grade in Escuela República de Honduras. Before of that, I remember I watched the Central American Games in San Salvador in 2002. And I really want to practice any sport. But my mom and my dad didn't have time because they was working a lot. And I want to practice sport, but I didn't have any idea how sport. And one day at the school, the federation made an exhibition from wrestling. But I remember I didn't know the wrestling was for fighting.
I watched they made some gymnastic, and I love it that, and I felt really interested, but when I was a star, was a playing, like a gymnastic round, but didn't fight, but. Almost 2 months ago was my first competition. And I fight. I didn't know what I do, but I won the first fight. The first fight I won, and I lost my second fight, and I won a silver medal. And I feel really happy. And my mom and my dad support me every moment. And I continue during 15 years completing.
Wow.
I remember, I think I didn't know how I can start in wrestling. Mm-hmm. But then I like it because wrestling is one of the most sport that you can run, have a flexibility and gymnastic and techniques.
So
it's complete. Uh-huh. And unfortunately, I didn't have bad situations because I never broke
any part of your body.
Any part of my body. Was when I need to lose weight was so difficult because I didn't have a diet. I was running a lot of time. But then when I won or when I fight, when I have the opportunity to represent El Salvador, I really feel really good.
Amazing. Yeah, thanks a lot for sharing your experience. Well, you were 9 years old, so that must have been a big, an important moment for you to get a medal. So thanks a lot for sharing that. Guys, we do have time for a couple of you more. So I want to have volunteers. I'm not asking like victims today because it's the last day and it's your opportunity to shine. So who wants to be next? Nobody. So can I have victims? Is there any volunteer, guys? ¿Alguien quiere contarnos su historia?
Me, teacher.
Yes, Norbert, go.
Me, teacher.
Yeah, okay, good. So let's listen to Norbert first, and then we go with Clary. Norbert, 1:30, go.
Okay, teacher. One day is in the morning, my cousin, in France, and then we went to the rivers to take a shower, to take a lunch, the chicken soup. The river was very visited for the people, the my town's paradise. The rice name is Hibua.
Okay.
Return in the afternoon at 5 p.m.
Okay.
It is for 1 kilometer. In other occasion, I am visited Aurora Zoo in Guatemala City. The soil is big, have much animals, kitten, like giraffe, monkeys, snake, fish, penguins.
Okay. All
sides of the world.
Time is over. Wait.
Okay.
Okay. Yes.
It's a play very nice.
Yeah, yes, I have been there, pero no vi los pingüinos. I didn't see the penguins. Mm-hmm. So thanks a lot for that. Guys, todavía no se vayan. Wait, we have to take the picture. Hold on. Okay, Clary, you got some time. Go, Clary.
Okay, miss. 10 years ago, traveling to Cali, Colombia. It was an 18-month stay. The reason for my trip was to teach the gospel of Jesus Christ. I was missionary in my church. I meet many friends, Argentina, Chile, Peru, Bolivia, Ecuador, Guatemala, Costa Rica, many, many friends. It's that experience was very nice. I want, ¿cómo puedo decir? Quiero regresar otra vez. I want to go back again.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. I was back again.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Amazing. No, that's beautiful because okay. you were traveling for something amazing, right? That is to accomplish your dreams. So great to hear that. Okay, guys, look, that was amazing. As I said, I was asking for volunteers more than victims today. So you did it nicely. I'm going to take the last 3 minutes that we have for today. Just to thank you, right, for all number one, commitment, por el compromiso, por la asistencia, you know, por la responsabilidad con las tareas, con la plataforma. Estar acá, yo sé que no ha sido easy, ha sido un año bastante complicado y hemos estado juntos, digamos que casi el año, but it has been just amazing escuchar el progreso, escucharlos and escuchar, number one, que su listening ha mejorado, your vocabulary is improving, y que se comunican de forma mucho más fluida, you know, that your pronunciation is getting better. So, solamente los invito a que sigan, you know, continue this way, continue this process, no se den por vencidos, practice, speak as much as you can, y estoy segura pues que lo van a lograr. So, this is the end of module number one. Pues ya el siguiente piel va para el intermedio. That's gonna be for intermediate, right? Así que I'm super proud of you guys. Just keep it up. So this is like beginner level is over. Ya se terminó el módulo 6, guys. Congrats, you did it. Very, very nice. And tengo un par de awards for you. So hold on. Okay, yeah. Tengo special mentions de los compañeros que subieron juntos desde el módulo 1. No sé si se me escapó alguien. Intenté hacer memoria and I think this is what we got. So I got Anita, Brian, Jackie, Jocelyn, Norbert, los hermanos, you know, Marvin and Renee. Clary and Moses and Brenda, if I'm not wrong, están juntos desde el módulo 1, así que thanks a lot, guys. I know that a veces han querido, like, oh, I don't want to continue, pero ahí estamos, you know, so thanks a lot. El grupo es súper bonito, cuídense, you know, take care of each other, que siempre se unen. My second mention is for the most participative. Thank you guys so much for ponerle el alma, corazón y hacer que, you know, la clase se vuelva super interesting, por compartirme siempre sus historias, por estar ahí, mi teacher, you know, that's amazing. So I got Dennis, I got Guadalupe, I have Ignacio, Richard, Karina, Carlos, Mabel, thanks a lot guys for being there, super participative. And I have my last mention for the most persistent guys I have seen. Yo sé que han tenido un par de dificultades, you know, de salud, técnicas, work, etc. Pero siempre los veo conectados, you know, and I see you there. So I got Denny, I got Eduardo, you know, que casi no lo hemos escuchado, Eduardo, but I have you there. I got Saraí, I got Claudia, thank you so much for you know, estar súper pendientes y espero que siga súper mejor de salud, Claudia. Marvin, thanks a lot, Marvin. Yo sé que lo estaba molestando mucho, but thanks a lot for being here. I get Nelson, I totally understand Nelson, y gracias por siempre estar viendo, conectándose. Pedrina, yes, Pedrina, lo logramos. We made it, definitely, we did it, you know, and we complete this module. So, gracias chicos, gracias a todos, you know, porque sé que ha sido un esfuerzo personal, you know, estar acá a participar, you know, hacer las tareas and everything. Recordemos que tenemos solamente el día de ahora para terminar la plataforma antes que se cierre. And I want to take a picture. Voy a tomarles las fotos, la foto ya oficial, you know, the ending of the module. So please ayúdenme con su camarita. No importa que estén medio desmeluchados, it doesn't matter, you know. Doesn't really matter. Me falta López, Marvin López, Clary, Claudia, si pueden un momentito solamente, you know, turn on your camera, you know, que no quede el espacio, you know. Jackie, yeah. Dani, no sé si Dani está ahí.
Dani Anthony.
Dani is there.
No.
No veo no. Su audio activado. Girls, can you? Ya veo Clary, thank you. Nice. Me faltan los demás. Brian. Mr. López está por ahí. Acabo de ver a Brian. Ya se fue.
No, acá estoy.
Oh, es que está conectado dos veces. That's why. I didn't see you before. Bueno, ni modo. Los demás se fueron. No veo a Eduardo either. No, I don't see him. Okay, that's good. Okay, guys. Oh, y ahí está Claudia. Hello. Thank you. Sí, pues sí, Miss, para que nos parezca
su espacio René, en igual.
Negro, you know. René, where are you? No, a René lo acabo de ver, I saw him. Oh, yeah. Okay, there you go. Okay, guys, let me take the picture. And, espérame que Dani se fue. Okay, vaya, sonrían, guys. Ahí está. Okay, thank you guys. Thanks everybody. Ya les envío la foto. Thank you so much. Solo me ayuden con la plataforma, please. Y espero verlos más adelante, you know, hablando súper genial, you know, communicating. Y pues ya vamos a tener una full English conversation. Ha sido un placer estar con ustedes. Que disfruten su noche. And espero verlos pronto. See you guys.
Tienen que pagar la apuesta, Marvin.
Las pupusas. Brian,
la Marvin y René.
Okay. Nunca fuimos.
Es cierto. Lo que pasa es que tenemos
Chapán.
Tenemos del Paraíso de Osorio. Tenemos a Marvin ya vino. Hi, Marvin. Deberíamos ponernos de acuerdo, you know, y conocernos aunque sea así a kilómetros de distancia.
Yeah. Con la cartilla de vacunación.
Es que habíamos dicho es cierto, habíamos dicho la vez anterior con creo que Brenda, Brian y Danis. Yeah. Que íbamos a ir por las pupusas, yeah. I think, but I'm not sure.
Sí, Marvin igual iba a ir.
Vamos.
Vamos. Gwen.
Vamos.
Espérenme. Bye. Ha sido un placer, guys. Bye.
Bye, Brenda. Bye, Danis.
Bye,
Brian. Bye, Moses.
Bye. Vemos.
Good
night. Bye,
guys. Bye, Karina.
Give me 1 second. Solo limpio acá el queue. Creo que Cari, ya que está acá. Ahí está.
Okay.
Thank you. No, okay, sir. Thank you, Miss. Sir, it has been amazing. Solo quiero comenzar con un poquito de feedback. Okay. So, super good. From last level to this module, la siento más fluida. So, I feel that you're getting more fluency. La siento con mucho más vocabulario y que piensa menos. A lo que me refiero es como piensa menos en las palabras que tiene que utilizar y ya intenta hacerlo. I was listening to the story today, súper bien, you know, muy buena estructura. I was like, súper claro, porque a veces cuando leemos la pronunciación, cuesta un poquito porque no logro entender todo lo que están diciendo, pero mm-hmm. lo escuché y súper claro, you know, muy buena pronunciación. That was very nice. That was good. Okay. How do you feel? Now, eso es lo que yo he percibido. Now, no, tell me, how do you feel?
Así, tal cual, que más suelta.
No. Okay, sí, great,
Del mes pasado para acá, súper más suelta. Y que como con el cambio y el grupo que ya estaba bien consolidado, como que no terminaba de aterrizar, pero pues poco a poco intenté ir participando todo lo que podía y ahora ya me sentía más suelta, la verdad, ya sí. con menos estrés en qué quería decir, porque ya así nomás me salían varias cosas, solo que, bueno, no sé, siento que sí me sale más fácil, pero como una estructura sencilla, digamos, que yo sí le expliqué la historia, pero yo siento que ocupé palabras súper sencillas y todo, pero no, pero quizás sí, ¿qué más le iba a decir? ¿No?
Lo que sucede es lo siguiente, probablemente siente que la estructura es como muy básica, que está utilizando Ajá. vocabulario básico, entonces sí. hagamos lo siguiente, let's do the following, intente contarme la historia, try to tell me the story, con la estructura básica, eso no hay ningún problema, pero agrégueme detalles, todos los detalles que pueda, as many details as you can. Creo que tenemos tiempo. Bueno, inténteme contar la historia de tal vez no la del perrito, ya no.
No, comentriste.
No. Not your dog story, pero sí me puede contar otra historia. For example, tell me the most memorable moment in your probably university, in your school days, in your high school, but dígame mucho detalle, give me a lot of details.
Solo que yo me voy a disculpar, pero a mí sí me está esperando mi hermano porque tengo que hacer un trabajo.
Ah,
y ya estoy
okay.
como sobre un poco tiempo. Tarde. Sí, me tengo okay. que conectar con él. Y
no,
yo quería
fine.
Aprovechar para hacerle una pregunta de una... Nada más una palabra que encuentro que es like. Entonces, yo entiendo que like y como la puedo usar es que me gusta o algo así. Pero yo la he visto en como que la usan en otro sentido o en otro contexto. Entonces, le quería preguntar en qué otro contexto y cómo hago para identificar dónde la puedo poner.
Claro, la palabra...
Creo que la he visto también.
Como retomar.
No, okay. de tomar o de... No.
Okay. Like, esta palabra, ¿verdad? Like es de gustar, pero exacto. también like sería un como nuestro como.
Como, exacto, así okay. la vi. Pero, ¿cómo sé cuándo usar? Porque como es as también, ¿verdad?
Digamos que es el mismo uso de as. So, por ejemplo, si yo le digo, me gusta, déjeme pensar en algo, like, what is it like? It's like, normalmente lo utilizamos de esa forma, it is like. Uh-huh. So, cuando se vea it is y luego un like, eso sabemos que no se puede, no podemos tener uh-huh. dos verbos juntos. Uh-huh. Entonces, lo más acertado es pensar que es como, yeah. I'm sorry, I got allergies. So, imagínense que estamos hablando de un lugar, right? We are talking about, no sé, el Hospital del Salvador. Nunca uh-huh. he ido, pero imagínense. So I tell you, oh, el Hospital del Salvador, it is like first world hospital, you know? Uh-huh. So, este like, uh-huh. sí viene funcionando como un as, pero es diferente, it's just different. Este no es para comparar, uh-huh. solamente es para dar un ejemplo. Esto es bien común que lo utilice o que lo escuche. It is like. Uh-huh. Uh-huh. Or I'm like. De hecho, yo lo uso bastante esto. I'm like. Pero el like lo utilizo más como una muletilla, digamos.
Uh-huh.
Como uh-huh. un este. Uh-huh. Uh-huh. Como una muletilla cuando usted necesita pensar un poquito. So, uh-huh. no se preocupe mucho del significado. No tiene mayor... con significado here, solamente es como el uso.
Uh-huh. Ajá, es que me confundí un poco porque estaba leyendo ayer o algo, vi, creo que en una canción, ya ni me acuerdo de ayer o antier, vi uh-huh. como en una canción y me quedé con el pendiente de preguntarle y cabal, les voy a aprovechar aquí, que yo, como le digo, lo entendía como algo de que me gustaba algo, pero en la canción el contexto no iba por ahí, sino que iba más como un cómo. De hecho, hasta traduje el pedazo de la letra y era así como. Y yo dije, mejor lo voy a preguntar porque no sé cuándo se puede utilizar como cómo.
No hay una regla, there is not a rule, pero en nuestro español, si usted quiere decir cómo, pero no del verbo comer, ¿verdad? Sino que uh-huh. como una, digamos, una media comparación, entonces sí sería un like. Uh-huh. Uh-huh. So, yeah, like when you say cómo. Yeah, I cannot think, porque no hay una regla, there is not uh-huh. a rule. Uh-huh. But let me see, si logro encontrar algún par de ejercicios or anything, yo con gusto se los comparto. I'm gonna be checking that. Uh-huh.
Uh-huh. Ahí a veces no practicando worries. Con ejercicio a uno se le queda como más claro.
Uh-huh. O alguna lectura, déjenme buscar, uh-huh. let me check it out. Uh-huh. Okay. All right. No worries, thank yo sé que se tiene que ir, not a problem. Sí. Okay, I'll be seeing you around. Thank you so much. You're welcome.
Nos veríamos.
Have a good night. Have a good night. Bye-bye. Adiós.